Selman, who is the co-founder of CPROP. Would you give him a welcome?
Hey everyone. Some of you may be surprised to see me up here because if any of you have met our team, you've met my partners Adam and Luke, you know they're the loud ones. I'm the quiet one. But after 3 days in Kyiv, I'm the one that's not totally hungover. You can all identify with that. Alright, our project CPROP. Our project is about leveraging blockchain technology to deliver transactional efficiencies in the global real estate market. Now, as many of you know, real estate is one of the best applications for this technology, and there's a lot of other companies coming to the market in this space. And what I'm going to show you today is why our project is different and worthy of your support. But before I go there, let me tell you a little bit about how the co-founders came to this project. My partner Adam Kohler, he co-founded a startup called d10e, which automated document generation in residential real estate. Adam and his co-founder sold that company to Zillow for over $100 million in 2015. Luke Sestito and I, and one of our other companies, are working on a project with Jones Lang LaSalle, the global real estate firm, at the C level to leverage technology that we're designing a program leveraging technology to help some of the largest commercial real estate asset managers in the world operate their portfolios more efficiently. So through this collective experience, Zillow, JLL, many other very large global players, we were able to witness firsthand the transactional inefficiencies that persist in this global real estate market. And what occurred to all of us is how blockchain technology can be leveraged to improve performance, saving time and money for everybody. So when we conceived this business, we were out to accomplish three things. First of all, we wanted to address real-world problems that had serious financial drivers behind them. Number two, blockchain technology had to be a core component of the program, including a token design that's fundamental to the platform and its efficient execution. The third thing is that we wanted to make sure that we had a practical, near-term path to revenue, and we were designing to build a business that was going to be built to scale. So after going through all these criteria and working the problem, we identified the residential cross-border transaction market as our initial target market. So this slide shows the business model. I know there's a lot to look at on this slide. I'll move out of the way. Whoops. All right, looks like the animation is gone. All right, we'll wing it. So let me start with the top right-hand part of the diagram. I think there's a pointer on here, is there? I don't think there's a pointer, okay. Top right-hand part of the diagram is about tokenizing deeds and mortgages. There's widespread agreement in the industry that over time, deeds and mortgages are gonna become widely tokenized. And yes, there are many companies that are working on it. There are blockchain companies working on it. There are banks working on it. CPROP is going to offer the service too, but we are positioning to integrate with other companies doing this as and where it makes sense. One of the themes of this conference and of this industry is that blockchain technology is early in its development, it's early in its market adoption. And so, from that standpoint, we're positioning our platform so that we can integrate with other companies and banks that are developing blockchains in this field. So now let's focus on the middle of the diagram. Our logo is. This is the CPROP platform itself. So I'm very pleased to announce at this conference that we have formed an alliance with a San Diego-based company called MREN. That's M-R-E-N, you can look them up on the web. They spent the last 4 years and almost $10 million developing and commercializing a collaborative, relationship-based workflow management system specifically for commercial real estate. And by partnering with MREN, they will accelerate our time to MVP, and they will accelerate our time to ICO. If anyone wants to see an alpha version of this MVP, just let us know. We'll be happy to show it to you. So, now let me go to the bottom part of the diagram. I don't know if you guys can all see at the back, but what it says at the bottom are real estate portals in different countries around the world. Here we will integrate and not compete with existing real estate portals around the world. Why? Because they already have web traffic and they have rich databases. Those are big strengths, right? I think we can all agree on that. What's their weakness? Their weakness is that they don't communicate with one another, which is a real impediment to transacting internationally. We're in talks with some of the largest real estate portals in China and Brazil. Is that 5 or 10? Okay. All right, so next I'm going to go to the service providers. Service providers are essential to any real estate transaction, and one of the reasons we partnered with MREN is that their platform focuses on service providers, bring service providers to the platform, and users of our platform would have access to those as well. Next, on the left-hand side, we talk about alliances. We're forming alliances with other blockchain companies to bring added functionality to our platform that complements what we're doing, such as crypto-backed loans, crypto payment gateways, and so on. Another functionality is the ID tokens that you can see on here that accomplish KYC function, and they're essential to the tokenization of deeds and mortgages. And then finally, our CPROP token, which I know a lot of you guys are interested in. This is the token that powers the platform. It'll be an ERC-20 token. It allows buyers and sellers to transact on our platform with a single token. Because of our alliance partners, the integration, we're expecting to be working with a number of other companies that are transacting on other currencies and other tokens, and to provide a simple UI for users to our platform. Having a single token is an efficient way to do that. Furthermore, we're using that token to incentivize buyers and sellers to provide ratings of service providers so that our platform is self-curated. Here are the key team members. I talked a little bit about the co-founders. We've established regional teams in China, Middle East, and Brazil. These teams are led by highly experienced entrepreneurs with deep regional networks. And really importantly, we know these guys really well because we've worked with them for years. Our current advisors include the lead developer on the PureCoin project because of his work with the Pure Assets Protocol, which we think is a really interesting technology for tokenizing, driving down the cost of tokenizing deeds and mortgages. Over the next few weeks, we're going to be announcing a number of other alliances and advisors, so stay tuned for that. So here's our token structure showing allocation and uses. So look, this is the first unveiling of CPROP in public form, and we selected the d10e to do this because we were expecting to get some honest feedback for our project so we could improve, and we're not disappointed. So I want to thank everyone who spent time with us to share their thoughts. Here's where we are on the timeline. Right now we're conducting a limited token sale to early adopters who share our vision, see our vision, and want to join our project. Over the next few months, as we build alliances with other blockchain companies, we're going to be doing targeted token sales to members of those blockchain companies at pre-ICO prices. And the funds raised during this period are going to be used to launch our MVP, which we're scheduling for the end of the year. Based on that schedule, we're then positioning for an ICO in the first quarter of 2018. And that's pretty much it. So I want to thank you for your attention and open for questions.
We probably got about 1 minute for questions, if anyone has
legal any. Where is legal entity? In the United States?
Yeah, so we're based in the U.S. The parent company that holds the IP is a company called Crypto Properties. It's a Delaware limited liability company. And I guess because we're in the U.S., we like to surround ourselves with lawyers. Presently, they're advising us to set a foundation up in Singapore. So that's the path we're presently going down. Anyone else?
Yeah, it's notoriously difficult to get local jurisdictions to cooperate in terms of title and all of that. So how do you intend to address that?
Yeah, so that's actually, I'm glad you asked that question, because the same question applies to the tokenization of mortgages as well. You have to get the cooperation of the banks to do it. So essentially, the way we're addressing that is the tokenization of the deeds and the mortgages will happen when and where it will happen. No one has any control over that. What we wanted was a near-term path to revenue, so that's really the middle part. We can make ID tokens whenever we want, but by one of the things you see here under the platform is document generation. What we're positioning is to auto-generate documents, which will then lend themselves to be able to be tokenized when and where it happens. So we're not dependent upon that. I think I'm out of time. All right, thank you all again. Appreciate your time.